In this video, we will explain how to install the enterprise version of LiteSpeed Web Server on the DirectAdmin Web Control Panel. Before we begin, you will need to have DirectAdmin installed with full SSH root access and a working copy of Apache HTTP server. You will also need to remove any Apache replacements or reverse proxies such as Nginx over Apache or Varnish. And lastly, you will need to open the following ports: 7080, 80, and 443 for TCP, and 443 for UDP. Once these prerequisites are dealt with, we can dive into the following topics: obtaining a LiteSpeed Enterprise license, installing LiteSpeed Web Server, verifying that LiteSpeed Web Server is running, setting up caching for all WordPress installations, and switching between LiteSpeed and Apache. Obtaining a LiteSpeed Enterprise license. This step is optional. It is possible to complete all of the steps in this video with a simple 15-day trial license. Just be aware that once the trial period is over, you will need to purchase a license if you want to continue using LiteSpeed Web Server. If you need help choosing an appropriate license, see the link in the description. If you would like to use a trial license, you can skip ahead to the next section of the video. To purchase a LiteSpeed Web Server license, visit store.lightspeedtech.com in your browser. Choose the license that you would like to purchase and click Order Now. Choose a billing cycle, select a caching product, and click Continue. If you are not sure what type of caching you need, choose LSCache Standard, which is included for free in every license. Click Checkout, enter your personal or company details, select a payment method, and click Complete Order. If you don't have a LiteSpeed account, you will create one during checkout. An invoice for your purchase will be sent to your email address. This invoice will include license details, but you may also find the serial number on your account homepage. Look in the Your Active Product/Services section where it says Serial. Copy this to your clipboard since you will need it for the next step. Installing LiteSpeed Web Server. There are three ways to install LiteSpeed Web Server in a DirectAdmin environment. We'll show you all three and you can choose whichever method you prefer. Method 1, the Custom Build plugin. DirectAdmin provides a web-based GUI tool called Custom Build, which will allow you to install LiteSpeed Enterprise. Here's how. Log into your DirectAdmin dashboard and navigate to Admin, then Extra Features, then Custom Build, then Edit Options. Scroll down to the PHP Settings section and set PHP 1 mode to LSPHP and PHP 1 release to 8.2 or a recent PHP version of your choice. Repeat the process for the remaining PHP mode and PHP release settings, using a different version of PHP for each. Scroll down to Web Server Settings and paste your LiteSpeed Enterprise serial number into the LiteSpeed Serial Number field. Select LiteSpeed on the Web Server drop-down menu and click Save. Scroll down to Related Pages and click Build Software. Click Build on LiteSpeed. When the LiteSpeed build process is complete, scroll down to the Related Pages section and click Plugin Logs. Check Date and open the latest log. Take note of the admin panel address and admin password in the log file. You will need them to access LiteSpeed Web Admin Console in the future. Method 2, Command Line Interface. You can install LiteSpeed Web Server with or without an options file. First, we'll demonstrate how to do it without one. Connect to your DirectAdmin environment via SSH and run the get.lightspeed.sh installation script. You can either provide your license serial number or type out the word trial to start a 15-day trial period. We've put the exact commands in the video description in case you would like to copy them. The installation script will begin by prompting you to answer a few questions. We're not using an options file, so type Y and press Enter to proceed. Select a default PHP version from the available options and press Enter. Select a second PHP version prompt or type No in lowercase letters if you prefer not to install any other versions of PHP. Select third and fourth PHP versions in the same way. When all responses to each prompt have been provided, installation will proceed. When it completes, you will see a success message that indicates a randomly generated password for the LiteSpeed Web Admin Console. Please save this password in a safe place. Method 3, Command Line Interface with an Options File. This method is just like the previous method, except that you don't need to answer the PHP questions manually. Run the nano lsws.options command, and then add the desired PHP versions into the file. You can copy the exact lines from the video description if you'd like. To save the changes, press Ctrl plus O, press Enter to confirm, and press Ctrl plus X to exit out of the file. Now we can run the get.lightspeed.sh installation script as in the previous method, and it will install LiteSpeed Web Server without prompting. verifying LiteSpeed is running. Now that we've successfully installed LiteSpeed Web Server, let's verify that it's running. In the DirectAdmin Control Panel, navigate to Admin Tools, then Service Monitor. This will open a Show Services table. You should see a row for LiteSpeed and it will be marked as running. The PID column will show LiteSpeed's process IDs. Setting up caching. Let's get LSCache up and running for your server. LiteSpeed has provided a DirectAdmin plugin to make that simple. Download the DirectAdmin plugin from the link we've provided in the video description. On the DirectAdmin dashboard, navigate to Plugin Manager, then Add New, then Upload, and select the file that you've just downloaded. Enter your administrator password and click Install. LiteSpeed cache is important. The more sites on your server that are taking advantage of LSCache, the better your server's performance will be. So LiteSpeed's DirectAdmin plugin makes it easy to manage caching for all of the server's WordPress installations. First, we'll make sure that a cache route is set for all sites. Return to Extra Features and click LiteSpeed Web Server Plugin. Navigate to Manage Cache Installations, then Cache Route Setup, and click Set Missing Cache Routes to update all of the sites that don't have a cache route defined. Next, we'll install and enable the LSCache for WordPress plugin on all of the server's WordPress installations. Click Back to return to the LiteSpeed plugin's main page. Click Manage Cache Installations, and click the version number on LiteSpeed Cache plugin version. Set an active version for LiteSpeed Cache and click Switch Version. Note that the latest stable version of the LSCache plugin will always be selected by default. Click Back to return to the LiteSpeed plugin's main page. Click Manage Cache Installations once again, and click Scan to search the entire server for existing WordPress installations. The Cache Status column will indicate if the LSCache plugin is enabled or disabled for each website. Click the power icon to install the LSCache plugin on all selected WordPress sites. Use the Mass Enable Cache option to enable LSCache on all scanned WordPress installations throughout the server. To verify that LSCache is working correctly, visit the LSCache check tool in your browser and enter the URL for a WordPress site on your server. You will see a green LSCache is supported message and a LiteSpeed cache is a hit message. Scroll down to the HTTP header section and look at the x-lightspeed-cache header. It will have a value of hit. Switching between LiteSpeed and Apache. At some point, you may want to switch back to Apache temporarily for debugging purposes or for some other reason. LiteSpeed provides a command line method for switching back and forth simply. Connect to DirectAdmin via SSH and run the switch command with Apache as the argument when you want to switch back to Apache. Use lsws as the argument when you want to switch to LiteSpeed Web Server. These commands are listed in the video description. Let's take a look at a few of our most frequently asked questions. Why is the Web Admin console not reachable? It's possible that the Web Admin port is blocked by DirectAdmin's config server firewall. To allow list the LiteSpeed Web Admin port, navigate to Extra Features, then Config Server, Security, and Firewall, then CSF. Click Firewall Configuration and add the Web Admin port to tcp_in and tcp_out. Scroll down and click Change, then Restart CSF plus LFD. What if I see a failure message when I request a trial license? If you see a failure message during installation with a trial license, it's possible you've had a trial before. We keep a record of all licenses by server IP. If your server has been given a trial license before, it won't be able to request another automatically. Open a ticket from your client area or via email to support@lightspeedtech.com and request the trial extension. Will LiteSpeed automatically sync all of my current and new domains? LiteSpeed is a full-service drop-in replacement for Apache in a DirectAdmin environment. So yes, LiteSpeed will automatically pick up all of your domains hosted on the server. You may also add new domains without any error. Can I use DirectAdmin with Open LiteSpeed? Yes, DirectAdmin does support the open source version of LiteSpeed Web Server. Please see the link to the Open LiteSpeed documentation in the video description for more information. Congratulations! You have successfully installed LiteSpeed Enterprise in a DirectAdmin environment. If you face any issues with your setup, please see our documentation at docs.lightspeedtech.com or open a support ticket from your client area. Thank you for liking, sharing, and subscribing. See you soon!